Hello for Wednesday, January 28th. Well, I wanted to show you this one. This ADI, this one triggered yesterday. This is a situation right now. You may notice a lot of things trigger and they're not like really aggressive. Now, some have been okay, but a lot of them wimpy. They trigger just a little bit, then pull back and go up. We've had several that are up like 3, 4%. No, there's 5, 10, 20% lately. However, some of these are strong and they continue to move a little bit later. So we counted ADI as triggered on Monday because it did. I mean, it moved above this buy point and then it closed a little bit below it. But if you look over here, all these days, nice green days in a row, and then all the red days were very low. This showed it had good strength and it looked like it's going to continue. That's why we had a double a buy point, one at this 20, whatever it is, 2002, and the next one at 2060. And it got very close to that as well. 2054 is where it's at. Actually, it did, I guess, get a little above that. But I'm just pointing out that if some of these break out a little bit and pull back, keep watching them. If you're holding some, you may want to add to it on the second break, because there's some, many times they have been successful in doing that. So now we're looking at possible move again. It may consolidate first in the, in fact, quite a few excuse me, several stocks that may have touched a trigger point will leave as untriggered. We did count several that did trigger by a little bit, like PLT, but that one still could move higher. Several like that, you'll look at the watch list. RSG, that's been on the list for a while. ENZN, some of these trigger just a little bit, like ALKS. We counted it, but look, you can see that it's probably, if we have a decent market, it's going to move some more. Other ones that are real close, like MEDX, pay attention to that. MOT, Motorola, which has been on the list for quite some time. Other ones that were made new moves today, like COGO, NVIS, those are ones that triggered in the past, but then have built a new level. We didn't add them back to the list. But if you're paying attention to those, you'll see that they actually made another new level. We did put COGO on the blog so people could watch that. Okay, enough jabbering about that. Here's the Dow 15-minute chart. You can see not a lot of action. It ran up about, I forgot, over 100, and then it pulled back, and then it ran up, but stayed above this these basic 50-period EMA and, of course, this trend line here. So we're just seeing the Fed is going to have an announcement, I guess, on Wednesday. They have another day of meetings, I believe, but they'll have the announcement on Wednesday. Maybe they had a meeting on Tuesday, but the announcement anyway will come, so we'll see if that does anything to the market at all. But you can see the Bollinger Band's right up here, never broke above it. Maybe it will. If we break out above this area, this is the area to watch, do on a breakout. On a breakdown, it's really hard to say. You could draw another line up in here. I would say it'd have to probably break below this, you know, this level, 8120-ish. To be a decent short, other than shorting at the resistance, which some people like to do. On the Dow, no, I'm sorry, on the Russell 2000, they had another okay gains, about 5 points. But here we're looking at this top level, which is a 458.82, over here 457, so 458. Basically, if it can break out above that with good volume, you can look. We've got a golden cross going here. If it does break out, that will be a golden cross in the 15-minute chart. The next target above the 458. Remember, this one can get extended like it did here and push the Bollinger Bands up. In a short term, it can do that and just be cautious. But from this 458, we've got a 465. That's where we've got a line. That would be a point of resistance in the area to watch. Okay, additions to the watch list. We're not putting a lot on. Oh, before we get to that, you know, ERFW, ERF Wireless, this was a featured stock when it was down here at 20, and of course it ran like mad, over 200% ran up. So we alerted you several times as it's going up to use caution, because 200% is a bit much. And it got clear up to here above the top Bollinger Band, so it said make sure you keep those nice 200%, you don't lose those. And we expected the either short sellers or just profit takers to come in. Notice this, huge volume, over 100 million shares going up, and then down to only 100,000 shares, so wimpy on the pullback, and that's just what you want to see. Now, if it's going to continue, we don't know, but it just noticed that this had this shadow down here, and it closed right at the 50-day EMA. It's just one to watch for when the reentry is going to be. You know, this is long-term, and because they have this great Schlumberger contract, but you know, that's a 3-year contract plus a couple years extension. And but they've got a lot of equipment. If you look at the contract, there's like over 1,000 pieces of equipment. So, and this is a big deal because ERF has like the largest wireless secure network for oil and gas industry. Remember, they're remote areas. The only other way that these people can get this internet, these network systems really, is through satellite. And that's just hundreds of dollars a day. So this is a unique thing, and it's a big contract. You ought to read through it. But we just don't know where the point is where they start moving again. But obviously, over the next quarters are where we're looking for the biggest growth, not the next days. So right now, we're just watching to see where the base is built on ERFW. Good things in the future. Okay, Jack, some additions here. Look at this one. Over about 2340 is where the high was. Now, the vine needs to be stronger, but they do with everything. That's just, unfortunately, the way it is. But it's a decent chart, and look at all this time it's been consolidating this area since mid-December. So if you like the scalp stocks for like 25, 30 cents, and many do, this one might be one because it's fairly safe in this area. Oh, I shouldn't say that. I'll take that back. Nothing's safe. But you can see we got 2309 and it ran to 2340. So even in those little areas, you could get in and then see. But above 2340 with strong volume would be the way to go for hopefully bigger gains. Now, we have a financial ETF on the watch list already. But in case something happens with some news with one of the financials or the Fed, something like that, we're going to add FAS. Now, this is not for weak-hearted people because these 3x, three times, like 300%, they kind of like percent moves. They can really move quite a bit, as you can see here. This looked from 10 down to 750. So use caution. If you can see these areas, you have to pick a spot in here. But somewhere about this 1003 is one area here, and the next area up is about 1017 was its high in that area. But just pointing it out, FAS, if you like to play financials and have something that's quite volatile, and it can work both ways, you know, up and down. So how about Goldman? Goldman has kind of a level here. It's been trying to get back over the 50-day. Once again, we just put it on the list in case we do get some financial action. This one may be a one to keep an eye on to play over the $50. No, I'm sorry, not over $50. Over the $80.30, that is the 50-day EMA. Also, we've got ANT. This one, I've forgotten who mentioned, I'm sorry. This was a couple days ago in the chat room. They pointed it out, and then I noticed it pulled back, and then I thought, wait a day. Well, it pulled back some more, but the volume was lighter. So let's just watch it. So I said, let's look. This is some, if you like to trade stocks that are lower priced like this, it looks interesting because 159 here is the 50-day. I think if it breaks above 159, it'll probably just going to go past this 167, at least up to the 170. That's a good percentage move right there. But if the volume increases, then we could get something moving on this. Maybe not, but we're pointing it out to you anyway. A, I said N. That's because the letter H is an N in Russian. Sorry, it's A-H. T. No, is it an N? I have to look carefully. A-H-T, yes, A-H-T, okay. Next up, we've got CVN. Now, this has run quite a bit, as you can see, down from 1070 up to 14, and it's pretty much straight up, so probably is going to have to pull back. But there's been some momentum trades that have worked out pretty well, so let's just watch it. If it does, in fact, get momentum again above about a 1532, and probably you would sell a good share of what you bought even on the first day, depending on the volume, because it's moved up so drastically. If it goes sideways for a while and then breaks out, that's a different situation. And lastly, we've got MHS over about 44.53. This is the area here. Look at 44.90 was a little shadow. But I think over this 44.53 might be a possibility. Had increased volume on Tuesday. That's a positive sign. We got the 50 days starting to move up. So anyway, we'll see how that goes. And we've got others that are not yet ready. We're having them just watching them on the watch list for gold as that pulls back. Nova Gold, and you can see it has a pretty good setup, but we'll see how it goes as it pulls back. So hope you have a good trading day. I want to thank you for coming by the site, and we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Bye-bye.